participated in the conference in New York on the population growth, where I was given a chance to contribute twice, and I was able to meet even the big guys there of UNFP. We met them and we discussed, and I was doing advocacy for Uganda, which I think I did. And I tell them I support family planning. I have attended all these international conferences, even the one that was held in Indonesia, Addis Ababa, all these others. I'm always there. Advocacy is my work. To do advocacy, and I'm so grateful. But and you know, I read it from Proverbs. You quote and read it. Proverbs chapter 29, verse 18. It says, without vision, people perish. So, unless we have vision and we have passion for our people will perish and die. And so, I like that, and it provokes my ministry. Without vision, without revelation, without passion, people perish. And this is the force behind what we do. 10 years ago, when I was made a bishop in this place, I discovered there were some missing gaps in the area of education, in the area of health issues, in the area of work and development. And I felt that really, this is where I need to participate more, because development is very, very important. And when we talk about John chapter 10, verse 10, it talks about having life in abundance. And so we need to do that. It is a holistic ministry. So all these things we are talking about, some people find me there and say, how did you come here? Like in New York, I was there all about family planning, because it's about family life. And I support it 100%. Actually, I have 4 children, 4 boys, and many others under our care. And I said, now we need to support family life. And that's where I am. A God-fearing nation. That's number one. For God and a God-fearing nation. We want to see a God-fearing nation. We want to see a healthy nation. This was our resolution. All religious leaders, we want to see a God-fearing what? Nation. We want to see a healthy nation. We want to see an educated nation. We want to see harmonious nation. We want to see actually a welfare nation. These are 5 things as we just read that. We discuss all these things. We want to see a God-fearing nation. We want to see a healthy nation. We want to see an educated nation. We want to see peaceful and harmonious nation. And we want to see a wealthy nation. 5 points, and that's what we are after. So people may dwell much on politics, and others may say religious region, but for us, we are holistic ministry. Holistic life. And that's why what we are promoting. When we talk about family planning, which you love more, and we have other controversies in what we call in sex education, comprehensive sexual education. It's controversy. A lot of things are promoted there. It's hidden. We discussed it and say this is wrong for our children. And we thought that there are some issues like for children. You cannot discuss sex with a child of people, family planning a child of people, 9 years. You talk about, so we discussed it and said, but MPs, you are here. You need to take note of this. We see it. I have it on my table. We discuss and we underline this is wrong. There are some good things, and when it should be appropriate sexual education. It should be appropriate sexual education, whereby we need, this is what is needed for a child of senior one, of senior two. We need healthy people to use the roads. So it should be brought nearer. It should be brought nearer.